from Prince Edward Island, the East Pointers.
Thank you very much for that lovely, lovely, warm introduction back to England. We love England. We spent quite a bit of time here. We are from Eastern Canada, and we are polite by nature. We will encourage, we won't force people to dance. If you do feel so inclined, you're not going to hurt our feelings by standing up and moving to the music. This one's called Places You'll Go. It's a tune we wrote while we were on tour in Tasmania. If at any time I'm talking too quick, just put up your hand and tell me to slow down a little bit. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you so much, Shrewsbury. How's everyone doing tonight? It is an absolute honor to be here. We've heard so many amazing things from friends who have been here from Canada over the years, and it's all true, as we found out today. Thanks so much. Here's a set off our first record. It's called The Drift. Thank you. Feel free to dance, everybody. Don't be shy. Thank you very much. Amazing dancing. Thank you. Everyone's doing good? Great, great. On the fancy footwork there, all taught by his mother, which is my aunt. And on the four-string tenor banjo this evening is my older and wiser first cousin. This is Cody Chasen, everyone.
Thank you. I'm always waiting. Always waiting for you, just
what I'm gonna say, eh?
Something sarcastic. Well, I don't know.
You never know. I feel like being polite tonight.
It's about being polite tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're putting on the face of a polite Canadian. Three polite Canadians. Still out of shape. I've been trying hard this life. What did you say, Edwin? Oh, good dancing. How did you get up there? Oh, that's awesome. We're going to try a song from back home. Has anybody here ever been to Prince Edward Island? Okay. Has anybody here ever heard our good friends, Ten Strings and a Goatskin? Yeah. Good, 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 good. They've been talking up this festival for the last few years, and they're making us a bit jealous, to be honest. We're happy that we finally got to be here and get to experience this. It's amazing. But Prince Edward Island is kind of known for fishing, farming, and tourism. The fellow who wrote this song was a great friend of ours. His name was Mark McPhee. And unfortunately, a few years ago, we lost him to cancer at a very young age. But he wrote this song. We're going to try it for you. He wrote it for a friend of his who was lost in a fishing accident off the coast of PEI about 30 years ago. And it's called Blaney's Laughing Eyes. Hope you enjoy it.
Have you seen my buddy Blaney in your travels? Don't tell me silly stories about Davy Jones. Though he liked to joke and get the boss rattled, I think it's best if you just tell me where's his bones. Oh, you sailing salty seagulls, ease my grief with daring dives. Won't you lead me down the beach to where my missing body lies? Though they stopped the search, I still remember Blaney's laughing eyes. And I think I will until the day I die. I remember a quart of moonshine mixed with orange juice. Gary Blaine and I, we drank that sucker dry. We hit the crab balls from pulling whippies on the forklifts. We laughed it off, but thank God the tide was high. Oh, you sailing salty seagulls, ease my grief with daring dives. Won't you lead me down the beach to where my missing body lies? Though they stopped the search, I still remember Blaney's laughing eyes. And I think I will until the day I die. Oh, you sailing salty seagulls, ease my grief with daring dives. Won't you lead me down the beach to where my missing body lies? Though they stopped the search, I still remember Blaney's laughing eyes. And I think I will until the day I die.
Thank you very much. Cody and I come from, they say, seven generations of fiddle players and drinkers. And we are one of amongst, Cody has 120 first cousins.
I believe you just gave them the wrong impression of an entire family, Timothy.
Oh, that's okay. We're in the motherland here, I think everyone knows.
The motherland for the music, not for...
No. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Just being clear.
And... Cody has 120 first cousins. We share 55 of them. And there's, does anyone rival that? Not one person, really?
There's gotta be somebody in here that can rival that.
They won't put their hand up, though.
Oh, somebody over here, maybe? Wants to claim the throne? You don't want that throne, believe me.
But this, for the most part, all of her cousins can sing and play and dance or do something worthwhile watching. And this next tune is this next set of tunes are a set of tunes that we wrote and that are on our record, and we wrote it for our first cousin. We're getting through them. This one is for Morris. This one's called "Meals by Murray." So here we go. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. This is great. So we have a brand new album that's coming out on September 29th, and currently in the UK you can pre-order the album and you can listen to it on Spotify and all that kind of stuff. And this is a song that we wrote last year that's on the new record, and that's one that you can listen to online now. And it was whenever we were caught in a whole whack of bushfires in Tasmania last year, and it was pretty scary. And an older gentleman had told us that there were 82 fires that were on the loose, and it's the most they'd seen in a whole whack of years. So they were pretty worried, and we were supposed to play in this town called Chudley, and the show got canceled because the fire was so close to the town. And then they put it back on whenever the wind changed direction that evening, so they asked us to still come, and we're like, you sure? Because we're staying out in a log cabin in the woods that's even closer to the fire. But we wrote this song that day to keep ourselves sane, and it's called 82 Fires. I always wanted to be a drummer, but all the boys will let me take is this piece of wood and then a tambourine that's drilled down to another piece of wood with a lot of duct tape. So every time you hear this tambourine, which I like to call the Timbourine because my name's Tim, but I also just watched Joe over there and their tambourine guy's name's Tom and they call it a Tomarine. I thought I made this joke up and I just found out tonight.
I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that.
And
I
they call them Tomarini. And I said, no, mine's better than that. It's Timbourine. But then they said Tomarine, and I said, oh, crap, you got it. Anyways, enough of that. Enough of that. This one's called 82 Fires. I'll give her a go.
By the smoke that stings our eyes, we always knew that on this land we would live and die. But here we stand among 82 fires, speak our breathless goodbye. Oh, I don't know when the wind will turn. Oh, 82 fires still burn. Thank you.
you. Thanks so much. I'll tell one quick little story because I have to tell this at every show. This is in the 1970s, like in the mid-1970s, this is a quick history lesson, by the way. A lot has happened since the mid-70s. But our grandfather started what is called the Rollo Bay Fiddle Festival on Prince Edward Island. Has anyone ever been? I'm never going to ask that question again. That was an overwhelmingly silent response. But that's okay, because this is what this story is for.
It's growing.
It's about growth, Tim.
He
started it because in that time there was a really great concern that traditional music in the area of the east coast of Canada was dying, and it was a big concern. So all the festivals proceeds went towards teaching kids and adults how to play fiddle music and educate them in folk music in the area, and it was run by my grandfather and then our uncle for a number of years, and he passed away in 2015, and it was really uncertain whether the festival would continue, and it was going into its 40th year. And so Cody and I, a few of our cousins and Jake, we decided to become festival organizers overnight, and we ran the 40th annual Rollo Bay Fiddle Festival, which is the third weekend of July. We ran that last year, and the 41st annual was this year. So seeing this festival, really makes you, like, I used to not really notice all of the details, but I really, really appreciate what goes into running a festival. And because this is the only marketing currently that is happening for our festival, that's probably why you guys haven't been there yet. Next summer, from July 13th to the 15th, we also have a little music camp right before the festival as well. Basically, I'll see everybody at the Rollo Bay Fiddle Festival. We'll be there next summer.
Yeah!
I think the dramatic music in the background has helped. Yes, thanks, guys. But with that being said, I'll try a tune that my dad wrote, and then we'll rip into a few other tunes after that. So I hope you enjoy. Thanks. Thank you. That's Jake Charan over there on the harp, the guitar, and the piano. I wasn't sure if you're gonna find that harp in time, Jakey.
It's almost like someone hit it on me.
We did not hide it. We love it
now. Come on.
I'm just kidding.
I would never hide that on you.
We're going to try another set of tunes off the new record. This one's called Party Wave. It was inspired by our quick rise to fame in the surfing scene down in Australia for all the wrong reasons. Getting in people's way.
Yeah, there was one point we all ended up on the same wave together, and it was not pretty.
No. It was not. There was nothing graceful about it.
We think we ended up in the same wave. Yeah. We're pretty sure.
I know I was up on it. But apparently those are called party waves, so we figured, you know, it'll never happen again, likely. So we might as well celebrate it, right? You know? Yeah, you never know, right? You never know. So this one's called Party Wave. Hope you enjoy it.
Thanks so much.
Are there any David Bowie fans in here? All right. That's enough to do a David Bowie song, I think, for you guys. You guys can help us sing along. This one's called Heroes. Go back to 76, randomly, again. 1976 tonight.
It's a great year.
It's a great year.
It's a great year.
Dolphins can swim, though nothing will keep us together. We can be a thing forever and ever. Then we can be heroes.
Singing. We have one more here for you guys. We want to say a huge thanks to our front of house guy who puts up with us all the time from Prince Edward Island as well. Donnie Richard, thanks buddy. And to Drew back there, and to Luke and to Mike and to Chloe, and all the volunteers and everyone for having us here at your festival. It's been a treat so far, so thank you very much.
You can really tell when you pull in the gate at a festival with the parking attendants and everything, that's such a positive vibe, and it goes a long way. So thanks so much to all the volunteers out there.
And I'd like to thank Air Canada for deciding to finally send my banjo today. So thank you for that, Air Canada. There's a shout out for our Our nation's
5 minutes before sound check.
5 minutes before sound check. It rolled in.
And we're going to be back here tomorrow by 2:15 if anyone wants to come and have another little dance party. That's Jake Sharon on the guitar and the sneaky bass over there and the piano and the harp. Cody Chasen on the tenor banjo.
The stomp box, timbering, fiddle, everybody. It's Tim Chasen. Keep that clap going. Thank you. Thanks so much.
What did I tell you? Ladies and gentlemen, the East Pointers. Look at all these people down here dancing. How great was that? Do you want some more? I've got chills from that. Louder, do you want some more? You have no choice. Sorry, guys, the East Pointers.
Thank you so much. You can all stay standing up. We'll have one last dance party before we finish up. And we just want to mention, too, that we have some CDs over in the merch tent. We're not very good businessmen, are we? Forgot to mention that. But here's a set of tunes that I hope you enjoy. Here we go. Thanks again for listening. You guys are awesome.
Great night.
Thank you.
the East Pointers. Give it up for the East Pointers. How fantastic was that?